Good morning. Welcome to the forecast discussion for November 14th, 2019. Well, we are finally starting to get rid of this brutally cold air, but we're still going to be dealing with chilly conditions this morning. But by this afternoon, it'll feel much warmer. Okay, so it's still below normal, but at least we're out of the 30s, right? As we look at the current observations today, yeah, I know it's November. I get it. It's a little bit too cold. I get it. I've heard the complaints, but look, trust me, it's going to get better. As we look at the observations this morning, we have temperatures generally ranging from the mid-teens to upper teens over the northern interior, lower to mid-20s along the coast, a few mid to upper 20s in your urban areas. Winds right now are light and variable. They'll be developing out of the south as we head towards this afternoon, and temperatures will be rebounding into the lower to mid-40s. Again, I get it, it's still below normal, but at least it's above the 30s, so we're making progress. When we take a look at our surface map, you can see high pressure is pushing off the coast, and we have this cold front that is approaching from the west. This high pressure system will exit, and this cold front will bring scattered cloud cover today on through tomorrow. No real precipitation, that's all going to be focused over the Great Lakes, with some scattered snow showers developing around Syracuse and Buffalo this morning, maybe a trace to about 3 inches in some of your favorite lake areas. But for the most part, we're just dealing with sky cloud cover around here. Taking a look at the latest satellite picture, you can see those clouds are increasing throughout the region today with that warm air invading. This little low pressure system down here is going to be something to watch for Sunday night and Monday. Right now, we're thinking it's going to stay far enough off the coast to just produce some scattered showers on the immediate coast. But the primary concern is going to be the potential for some coastal flooding and beach erosion. Then we have another storm way out here around California that we're going to be keeping an eye on for Wednesday that has the potential of producing widespread heavy rainfall and potentially some frozen precipitation for the northern interior. So we'll keep an eye on that. Closer to home, you can see those clouds are increasing for today as warm air invades. So let's dive into our forecast for today. High pressure exiting, cold front approaching. Temperatures rising into the lower to mid 40s for highs today. For tonight, look for scattered or broken cloud cover with lows in the mid to upper 30s. For tomorrow, a series of cold fronts will move through, scattered cloud cover, that's about it. Look for temperatures to rise into the upper 40s to lower 50s. On Saturday, strong high pressure shifts from the eastern Great Lakes to the St. Lawrence River Valley. Meanwhile, this low pressure system starts to organize. Look for scattered cloud cover on Saturday with winds veering from the northwest to the northeast around 5 to 15 miles per hour. Temperatures on Saturday range from the upper 20s to lower 30s for lows and mid to upper 30s for highs. Yeah, it's going to be well below normal once again. On Sunday, this high pressure system shifts to the St. Lawrence River Valley. This low pressure system intensifies well off the southeast coast. Now, that's going to lead to what we call a pressure gradient, and that pressure gradient is going to produce easterly winds around 10 to 20 miles per hour on Sunday, which will be a bit of a problem. For one, it's going to transport a northern Atlantic air mass into the region, and that means cloudy skies. And yeah, there may be a few isolated showers right along the coast during Sunday afternoon. The primary concern is that those easterly winds are going to drive water into the coastal plain, and that means the potential for some minor coastal flooding and beach erosion. So I'll keep an eye on that. Sunday night into Monday, that low pressure system continues to track to the east-northeast. There's going to be a threat for scattered showers right along the immediate coast. Scattered clouds over the interior, no real impact. But right along the immediate coast, we'll watch to see whether we get some of these heavier showers to back into portions of Connecticut, Long Island, and the immediate New Jersey coast. Temperatures on Monday will range from the upper 30s for lows and mid to upper 40s for highs. On Tuesday, cloudy skies as another area low pressure starts to organize. So you have a lot of cloud cover lingering around the region. Look for lows in the lower 40s, highs in the upper 40s to lower 50s. On Wednesday, that low pressure system tracks up the coast. We'll have to watch out for some heavier rainfall along the coast, and potentially a rain snow mix, maybe a little bit of sleet for your higher elevations. I'm not expecting accumulation just yet, but definitely slick roadways are going to be a threat on Wednesday morning. Temperatures on Wednesday will range from the lower to mid 30s over the northern interior, upper 30s to lower 40s along the coast, and upper 30s to mid 40s throughout the rest of the region for highs. So it's going to be a bit of a raw day. On Thursday, another cold front will approach by the time we get to the evening hours with some isolated showers. Look for temperatures to range from the mid to upper 30s for lows and upper 40s to lower 50s for highs. That's your forecast discussion for today. If you enjoyed this forecast, please like, share, subscribe, and as always, let your friends and family know. And if you're looking for more in-depth weather information, please check out a subscription to NYNJPA Weather Premium Consulting Membership. Only $11 a month, less than a coffee a day. That is your forecast discussion. Have a wonderful day, and as always, stay safe out there.